everyone, Chelsea O Studio here, and today we are talking about fixing broken sketchbooks. Hey guys, welcome back to the studio. So I don't know how many of you have had this happen, but you buy a sketchbook and you're really, really excited, and then you get it home, put it in your bag a couple of times, and then bam, this happens. Listen, it happens all the time, and I wish they would build them a little better, just saying. But when you mass produce a sketchbook, especially one like this, a lot of times you get these open-ended spirals. So if you've ever actually looked at the back of these spirals, you'll see there's a gap between the spiral opening. I think that's just from mass producing them and being able to put them together more easily. But what happens is that the cover is just wide enough to be able to fit through there. So I'm going to teach you guys how to fix this and then also how to prevent it from happening ever again. If you treat it like a normal human and not some kind of crazy person, this fix will last forever. The first thing you need to do whenever you're trying to fix a sketchbook like this is turn the sketchbook over. Flip the back cover so that the front and back cover are touching. And that will, at the same time, turn the entire spiral so that you can have better access to this middle portion, which is where the back has fallen out of. What you're gonna do is you're going to, just one at a time, take the spiral spine prongs and re-interlace them with the back cover. And see the last part just kind of fit itself into place like a jigsaw puzzle. So now you can see that there's an open space here. The next thing that you need to do is get some sort of cord or string or yarn, anything that you have that is tieable. I just happen to have this jewelry making cord here. I also have some yarn, but I didn't really want to use this because I use this to make candle wicks. If you guys would be interested in seeing how I make candle wicks and how I use old wax to refill into new candles, let me know. But yeah, that's what this is for. You guys can let me know in the comments if you want to see that. So the third thing you do after you have gotten the cord is take it and lay it across the top of your spine. And then I usually like to be a little extra generous because I can be a little clumsy, so I need some tying space, and I like to go usually maybe an inch or two off of either edge, so like an inch or two here, an inch or two at the bottom, so that I have some extra room to tie with. So now I have that marked, and I'm just going to get my scissors and cut that off. Hair in my mouth. The next thing that you need to do is thread your cord into this first hook. So the first hook, I'm going in through the cord. If you have a sewing needle or an embroidery needle. Why is that so hard to say right now? If you have an embroidery needle, this might be a little easier. I don't have one right now, so. And then what I'm going to do is I'm actually going to take this and go under and through this square here. And then I will tie it, but when I tie it, I want to tie around this extra hook that doesn't have anything to ground it. So I'm going to tie all of these three together. A normal knot, either that first knot that you tie with your shoelaces, and do that, I don't know, three or four times maybe. And then you can snip the excess off, and that side should be good. Sometimes I like to hit it with a little bit of super glue just to make sure it doesn't fall out if this the cord is a little softer, like this cord is, so I probably will do that. But now I want to do, since I'm completely out of the spine now, I want to go underneath this first square, but then through the next hook. Just like that. And then for the next one, I'm going around through that next square, through the next hook, and then pull. And then I'm just going to do that all the way down the spine. One more time, real slow. Through the square, through the next hook, and pull. Okay, and we're going to do that all the way down the spine. Okay, it looks like I have just enough to get all the way down to the bottom, but what I actually want to do is I want to take the threads and the spine, and I actually want to pull them together up here so that I can pull the threads and the spines closer and just make sure it's super secure. And I'm just pinching and pulling all the way down the spine, just like that, nice and secure. And then with my extra, I'm gonna tie the string the same way that I did at the top, including this hook. If for some reason some of your hooks are bent and the spaces aren't nice and clean like this, maybe you've been using it and it broke after you were using it for a little while, all you have to do is rebend them back to their original place, and this should still work. I've had a couple that were torn apart like a slinky. I don't know how someone does that, but they were my sketchbooks. They were student sketchbooks. So then I'm going to go around and through this big square, and then that will loop this extra hook. And then I am just gonna go under that hook, through the big loop, and then I'm gonna come up through that loop I just made. So I just went in the hook, out the square, up through the loop, and I'm pulling. Just like that. And I will do that a couple of more times. So I held the string out to the side, go in through the hook, go through that square, and then take your thread up through the middle of the hoop and just pull. And I'll probably do it one more time just to be safe. Snip off the extra. If you want to reinforce with glue, you can, otherwise it should be good, depending on the kind of thread you have. I always have the best luck with embroidery thread, but I just happen to be out. And then you can just flip your cover back to the way it was, and ta-da! So the string is on, oh no, goodness, whoops, what happened to you? Sorry. The string is on the back page, so it shouldn't affect you at any other time besides this back page. And you can close the book and open it easily. You can yank on it and it won't come apart, you know, unless you're crazy. I've seen it happen, but it takes a crazy to make this thread come out. And that's it. Pretty simple. I do this with all my sketchbooks. I also do this with all my planners. I have this old planner here, and you can see that I had a green embroidery thread that I did this same technique to. But you do want to make sure you get that hook, because you can see that I didn't get the hook. I didn't get the hook here, and this page has come out the bottom. So just make sure you get that hook. Thanks so much for watching, guys. I really hope you try this out on your own. It's a super easy tip that extends the life of your sketchbook, and it only takes a couple of minutes. So please try it out and let me know how it goes. If you like the video, please like it down below and subscribe, and then hit that notification bell, because next week we're gonna have a special guest on my YouTube channel that's gonna be helping me out with a testing video. As always, if you want some more of my artwork, you can join my O Studio Print Club, where you get a amazing brand new 5x7 print every single month, a new 3-inch sticker every single month, and on your first month you get a membership sticker to that print club. If that's not in your wheelhouse, I do have prints, stickers, and originals on my website. And then for more artwork and some behind the scenes, you can follow me on social media. I do Instagram stories all day, every day, so definitely check that out if you're interested in what's going on behind the scenes. I hope you guys have a great rest of your day, and I will see you next week. Bye!